All earthly things with earth will fade away. The prayer grasps eternity. The prayer grasps eternity. It always startles me that the disciples never said to Jesus, Lord, teach us to preach. They never said, Lord, teach us to do miracles. They did say, Lord, teach us to pray. Prayer, Montgomery said, is the simplest form of speech that infant lips can try, and prayer is the sublimest strains that reach the majesty on high. Prayer will exhaust your vocabulary. I do not believe that any man or woman is greater than their prayer life. You judge your spiritual temper. I'll tell you how to judge your temperature spiritually. How much do you love to pray? Prayer is not a position, it's a disposition. That's why the Apostle Paul says that it is possible to get to that place where you pray without ceasing. Where every moment of your life, you're in an attitude of relationship to Him. Not for something you want, but that somehow God might come again and breathe. You see, the answer to America tonight is not in the White House, forget it. The answer to America is in God's house. But I'm convinced of this, God does not hear prayer. He hears desperate prayer. All we have to do is live with eternity's values in view. All we have to do is to know what God, the Holy Ghost, says by His Spirit in our hearts. You can impress other people, you can't impress God. You can even impress yourself, you're somebody. You remember John Knox prays one day when he gets to the end of the line, he says, listen, I don't want to live. If God doesn't breathe on my nation, I don't want to live. Give me Scotland or I die. If there's any prayer that needs to be prayed in the Church of God today, as far as I'm concerned, it is, Lord, teach us to pray. Prayer is almost, not quite, but almost the greatest human privilege that we have. You don't change overnight. We approximate to it. We get our muscles stronger and stronger in the place of prayer. You get to the place where you'd rather sweat, you'd rather weep in His presence than laugh in anybody else's presence. You'd rather God whisper a secret into your heart that breaks you. And somebody give you the prizes that all the world covets. I don't think I ever go to a prayer meeting but what I pray one simple prayer amongst others. And that is, Lord, teach us to pray.